All right, guys, welcome to another episode of Fun with Dumb. I'm here with two very good friends of mine. They're comics. They're writers on hit shows that you guys are familiar with. They're on hit shows as well as as actors.
Yeah.
And you will see us on hit shows in the near future.
There we go.
In the near future.
Hell yeah, bro.
Andrew Lopez. Biniam Bizuneh.
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 That's my favorite thing in comedy. Is everybody be like, this is my best friend.
We go way back. I love this dude was at my wedding. Yeah. This dude is my godfather.
Yeah, Bizuneh. Bizuneh.
Dude. This is my best friend ever. This is Gay Park.
Yeah.
Let me say.
Dude, I love you. What is it? Tardfounded?
Dumbfoundead?
Dumbfoundead?
Is that the same? Would that happen in battle rap ever where people were ever like, yo, I love you, bro. What's your name again?
Yeah.
No, I've had people come up to me like, I'm a huge fan, Dumbfounder.
You know? Dumbfounder. Dude, my favorite is this. Someone be like, oh, can I get a picture? And then while I get in the picture, like, what do you do again?
Yeah.
They just know there's some
I don't understand the psyche there. It's like, I guess just because you're famous, let me get a photo.
They're like, maybe it's like, let me get it in case. I don't want to be like 2 weeks from now, be like, that was fucking Brad Pitt.
Yeah.
Must have it in case.
They can get clout from posting it.
I guess.
Or like, what if you died and they could be like, I always knew him. He's cool. Yeah. I got the picture with Tard.
I gassed you guys up pretty heavy right now, so let me clarify what shows and things you guys are affiliated with. Biniam over here writes for a show called Dave, and have been for multiple seasons now. From
2 and 3.
You wrote some episodes that you guys might favor as well.
Yeah. Supposed to look into camera and be
No, I'm just talking to you guys.
Okay.
You've written on Dave, and you've also performed at My Comedy monthly, multiple times.
Mm-hmm.
Beast of a comedian.
Thanks.
Dude, you're good at this, man. It's like, wait, no, stop. What are you? So, when did you realize you could be an interviewer?
Dude, he didn't even do your thing yet.
I don't give a fuck.
He's got to do your
who I am, dude.
No.
They watch it for him,
Let me do a proper intro. Let me do a proper intro. Andrew Lopez here.
I can see it in his eyes that you're trying so hard
to think of
an intro. Nobody cares.
He's like, my friend Andrew Hernandez here.
Dumb is the kind of guy that would go to a show and be like, hey, bro, you should meet my friend, bro. This is my friend Kevin. And then Kevin will look at me like, I'm Hunter.
Andrew Lopez, also known as A-Lo.
wait. That is true.
Did they call you A-Lo?
Yeah. Did you think you just came up with that?
I was just thinking like...
No, it is. One time we took a picture in front of the store A-Lo. Because we were oh shit, the store has your name.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah.
Yeah. They did call me A-Lo.
That's
in high
A-Lo, pronounced A-Lo, though.
Yeah.
Oh, I called it A-Lo. I've been calling it A-Lo this whole time. It's come up maybe twice.
Dude, when I was, they used to call me A-Lo because in high school, J-Lo was like the big, she was going by J-Lo, and I used to take a pen and do A-Lo on my knuckles like this.
I like A-Lo.
Like it was hard as hell.
Dude, you should get that tattooed now.
Bro, one of my senior pictures is me doing this with A-Lo on there.
Yo, one of the most difficult things to do in my adult life has been finding the right doctor. One you can trust, one that makes you feel super comfortable. I'll spend weeks, sometimes months, asking for recommendations from friends, and they probably don't know any better than I do. But once I find that right doctor, I'll make an appointment, only to find out they don't take my insurance. That's annoying as hell. But don't worry, fam, I got you. And ZocDoc does too. ZocDoc will help you find and book the right doctor that'll actually take your insurance as well. ZocDoc is a free app where you can find amazing doctors and book appointments online. We're talking about booking appointments with thousands of top-rated patient-reviewed doctors and specialists. You can filter specifically for ones who take your insurance, are located near you, and treat almost any condition you're searching for. I use this, and you should too. It has made my life so much better. I feel much more safer, and I've prioritized my health. Go to ZocDoc.com/dumb and download ZocDoc app for free. Then find and book a top-rated doctor today. That's ZocDoc, ZocDoc.com/dumb, D-U-M-B, ZocDoc.com/dumb. Do it for yourself right now.
Well, I got an intro for you. You were just
listed as top 10 screenwriters to look out for.
Let's go. Oh,
wow. Wait, what is Tricked it? What's them. The title of that? What is it?
Varieties Screenwriters
Dude,
to
maybe
Watch.
Maybe you aren't good
2023. Varieties Screenwriters to Watch 2023.
Yeah. Okay. It's like the freshman list of XXL.
Yeah. It's like the freshman list. It's like JFL, but even better because it's like so, like all the people on there are like, yeah. He's got a movie in theaters. He's got a movie. Yeah.
I do want to say, I'm dumb. I don't know. I think
no,
writing.
No, he's dumb. What are you talking about? Yeah,
writing is hard. I don't know why I'm on that.
You
list.
Always say you've always said this every time we hung out.
It's hard.
Writing is hard. Writing is hard.
Yeah. Yes. It's not as it's not as hard as like actual jobs, I would say, but like it is I don't like being on that list, honestly. But
is it a lot of pressure?
Yeah, just because I don't think I'm good.
Yeah.
I think it is a hype
list. He's talking himself down. He's sold all these things. He's written these amazing scripts.
Right.
One of his scripts is like, so everybody's read it.
No, who cares?
It's
so
really
when
good.
Did you realize that you could be an interviewer?
Dude, but you didn't
I don't
even
know
say
if
his
I
other
could be
an
interviewer. I just like talk shit. Most of the people I have on here are my friends, so it's easier to talk to. It's not.
Did
like,
you ever think that you should, like, because you are one of the quickest people on your feet on in a lot of levels, whether it's dramatically on your feet, like if you're going to roast somebody or if you're going to do something funny. Have you ever thought about
doing improv?
Yeah. Like,
I don't have you ever thought of doing,
making people not like
have you? Have you ever thought of doing Asian Whose Lines Is It Anyway? I think it could be huge.
You know what's the funny thing about improv? Improv gets roasted a lot, right? In the comedy community. Yeah, like comics have a thing with people who do improv and stuff. But like we grew up on like Whose Line Is It Anyway? And when we used to watch that, it was good.
Think about this. Yeah. It was. Whose Line Is It Anyway? It's an all Asian cast. HSU, you get Stephanie to host. She's the Drew Carey of it. Mm-hmm. I think this could be
huge. I think so. You do it at the Line Hotel.
Dude, that would sell the Freeform like right now. Yeah, they would be so happy. It'd be like Sherry Cola, fucking
that's
who
like
else?
That's like one
Ken Jeong, you
that's like one medium I don't want Asian representation in, you know.
Did you ever do Wildin' Out? Did you ever do Wildin' Out? Because that is what Wildin' Out is.
I've auditioned for it.
Dude, I auditioned for it too.
You did?
Dude, can I tell you an audition story? Okay, I auditioned for Wildin' Out. This is like 2017 or something. I get there. There's all these people there who are now like huge black entertainer people, but then they were just like Vine people.
Yeah.
And Kel is there too.
Yeah.
Like Keenan
Wait,
and Kel.
So he didn't get it?
Dude.
How could you not cast Kel Mitchell, man?
Not only, hear this. Not only did he not get it, but I'll get there. So I'm in there.
Yeah.
We all go in and we have to do like, you got to do like an improv game and then you got to do like a rap roast where you either roast Kevin Hart or you roast Nick Cannon and you got to do like two bars.
Yeah.
And so we all had to go in there and do that. I make it to the next round. So Kel gets skipped to the next round. That's his prize for being Kel is that you still got to audition, but now you don't got to do the first round.
Got you.
So then we go in there and they make us split into two teams and they do Wild Style where we like roast each other. And I'm on the opposite team of Kel. And usually when they do Wild Style, people are roasting each other based on like stuff they know about them because they're public entertainers. You know, they're saying like, whatever, you got divorced from Mariah, you're a bitch or whatever.
Yeah.
But we don't know each other. These are just random ass comedian fuck. So they're just roasting each other's like shoes and shit. It's like not good.
Right.
No one's going after Kel. So I go, your audition for Wildin' Out, and that's pretty funny. I think we're all wondering, where's that Good Burger money?
Oh!
And dude, all the people like mobbed me, were like, oh, and, like holding me on their shoulders and shit.
Kel
was crazy.
Hot. He was pissed.
And
right?
Kel just came up to me. I was like, that's pretty funny, man. But he was like sad. And then none of us got it. No one. I thought I was going to get it because I was like,
How
I had the best
roast. How did Kel not get it, though? I mean, it's...
Bro, I saw him later. You saw it. Yeah. We did that.
You brought him out for
Dude,
a show.
I did a show, and I told this story, and then he came out and defended himself. He was like, they said I was too famous.
That was his thing?
Mm-hmm. Damn.
And now he's in Good Burger 2. He's doing great.
He is doing good.
Good Burger 2, biggest movie on Paramount Plus right now.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. That and Halo.
dude, I forgot
that's
Halo
a big
happened.
Ass budget joint though. I saw a trailer for season 2 and it looked kind of crazy.
Yeah, bro.
For
a
good but burger? I was like I didn't even know they had a season 1.
I think it was yeah.
Oh, for Halo.
You said for Good Burger? Yo, they spent money.
Okay.
On that
I got a Good Burger story cuz when Good Burger first came out in the theater, I went to an early audience test screening for Good Burger.
Oh.
It was so bad.
Dang.
It was so bad.
How old were you?
You're probably like 8 years
young. I was young.
Were you having to do the comment card as a 7-year-old?
I was young and I was still opinionated because it was so bad.
So you were like marking like strongly do not recommend as a 7-year-old?
Yeah, because look.
Do you even know what recommend means?
Now we think back on that and it's like a classic because it's Kenan and Kel and all that and stuff. Yeah, at the time, it was just like, why is there a Good Burger movie off of all that sketch? You know what I mean? And then we, at the audience score, they didn't enjoy it. The movie wasn't good or anything.
Really? Well, I thought it was fire, bro. Because I was one of those people that like, when I was, I literally think most movies I saw as a kid are 10 out of 10.
Man, this dude trying to get hired for Good Burger 3 right here.
I'll do anything, bro.
No, I'm not getting casted for Good Burger 3. What's up?
You would be good
at it, bro.
Not going to
be in Good Burger 3.
Dude, I would do anything at this point.
But you know what's hilarious is like I watched the trailer for Good Burger 2. I do not know the story. I'm sure they have some funny way of explaining why this is. But like they're still cashiers at Good Burger in this. And I'm like, this is a tragedy. They're like in their late 40s being cashiers. how is this anyway? Let's be honest.
Any one of us three could look like we work at the Good Burger restaurant.
For sure.
Like, we could be casted as one of the workers,
but
for sure.
But Keenan working there, I'm like, this is like, what happened in this man's life?
Yeah.
Like, I'm sure they have some way of explaining. Like, he's got to go back. He probably had some other life, whatever. Yeah. But like, It's kind of crazy. If I walked into like a Burger King and Kel and Keenan were working there and I didn't know who they were, I would just be like, these are kind of like old black men to be working.
Yeah. What's crazy about it though too is that they just play Keenan and Kel. Like Keenan is so famous at this point that it's Keenan being a cashier is weird to me because it's like, bitch, you're Keenan. Yeah. Like you wouldn't like, and it just, it kind of, it like takes you out of the reality. It's like David, like casting David Blaine as a lawyer.
Right.
You would be like, that's David Blaine. And I just can't get away from the fact that it's Keenan and
Keenan is like a sketch goat now, right?
Yeah, he's the best ever.
He's the oldest person, or he's been on the longest
out of anyone.
He saves like a lot of cringe sketches being there.
He's the best. Also, like, I think, I don't know when Lorne Michaels is going to retire, but I heard somebody say that like Keenan's one of the people who might take over for him.
Ooh, I could see that. That'd be pretty lit.
Seeing Keenan in a suit, it sounds like canceled.
Dude, imagine too.
I want to see that
shit. Dude, imagine too that people all tell those stories, but now it's Keenan. Yeah. Like, how would Keenan hire people? He'd be like,
funny.
Yeah, yeah. Everyone has their Keenan stories.
Yeah, yeah.
Where they're just like, I'll see you over the weekend. Like, is he doing it?
Can I ask you something about the list thing? Going back to that.
Yeah.
I want to ask you, what percentage of people you think made that list in the last, I mean, that list has probably been around for like, what, 20 plus years or something?
Yeah, since 2008, I think.
2008? Mm-hmm. What percentage of people on the Screenwriters to Look Out For list have gone off and actually made consistently movies once have disappeared?
I'm one of those people that got like almost like, because I looked at all the lists after that.
You did.
Only because I just wanted to understand.
Yeah.
And because I had imposter syndrome, actually, because I wanted to see what
you were just
asking.
Like, am I going
to
disappear?
Yeah, I think I'm going to be the one that disappears.
You want to see what level you sit in this?
Yeah, well, I don't even think I was trying to see what level I sit in. I think I was honored to be on it, but I think I already feel like I'm on the lowest level of it. I honestly feel that way because most of the people on there usually have a movie that's already coming out.
Oh, I don't know.
And so I think everyone I'm on the list with has a movie coming out but me. I have no movie in production, and they all have one done in the can.
Dude, it's a flex, though, because it's kind of like how when you see someone on the freshman list and they just have a couple features, but everyone knows how hot they are. Everyone's like, they're going to be the good, you know?
Yeah, but they become the thing. Sometimes they do.
Well, okay, I would say the XXL freshman list, the percentage of rappers did go off to be very successful
early
rappers.
On. Now I see the list and I'm like, I don't know who any of these people are. And I'm like, am I old or is the list not as popular?
I think it's a little bit of both.
Okay.
I think it is a little bit of both.
Well, I think it's just longevity is so different because back then when you got it on the old freshman list, it would equal, I have runway to continue my career. Now I think you have to capitalize in a shorter time.
Also, it was like before the internet was when those lists were like crazy, when it would be like,
that's how you found people out.
Yeah. Yeah. But now it's like, there's so many people who are just huge on the internet and they don't need to be on the freshman list. They already have their huge ass. So it's like the freshman list isn't for people to know who they are. It's almost like the freshman list is like happy to get them.
It's reflective as opposed, like the freshman list is picking people that are blowing up as opposed to this is what's going to blow you up.
Exactly.
But I think that like if you look back on those lists, there's some really cool names on there. There's people like, you know, our friend Brian Duffield was on there, who just came out of the movie on Hulu. That was like the biggest movie of the year.
I thought you were talking about The Freshman. That's for a second. I was like, Brian?
Brian Duffield.
Dude, you didn't know he raps? Yeah. Dude, if someone could be on both lists, the only person who could maybe do that would have been Donald Glover.
Yeah.
There's no one else.
Maybe I'll make that list.
Maybe. Dude.
Well, dude, if you made...
I'm too old to be a freshman on the list,
here's
bro.
Here's a question. If you got on those
lists... Has any
lists,
Asian been on the freshman list?
Jin.
Anderson Paak?
I don't think Jin's ever been on the list.
If Anderson Paak counts as Asian...
No, he was on the same year that Dickie was on.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, here's a question.
There's an episode about it, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think he was the only one that wasn't there, I think.
He was too busy.
Do you think Lil Dickie is more famous as Dave, or Lil Dickie's more famous as Lil Dickie?
That's a good question. I think as Dave.
Now that the show has been out for a while.
That's true.
Whatever, yeah.
In the first season, though, obviously, Dickie.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Second season, I think probably Dave. Probably at that point.
I think, yeah, because I also think the synonymous part of that is being more famous as Dave feels more like he's more famous as a creator than as a rapper. Lil Dickie would be, I'm more famous as a rapper.
Do you think Gambino is more famous as Donald Glover? Or was there ever a point where he was more famous as Gambino?
That's a question he's asking himself every single day.
That's why he keeps trying to shed.
Yeah, I mean, Donald's at home being like, what am I more famous as?
I will say this, as a rapper who is also a multi-hyphenate, who does acting and stuff, like, that rapper part of you never leaves you, and there's something always to prove as a rapper, so I'm sure they go through the same thing. Dude. Like, I never, you know, it's different for Donald Glover because I think he's reached pretty massive success as a musician. Like, he headlined Coachella, which is pretty massive, you know? So he did take his music career to the top. I think Dave hasn't been able to do that, not because he's not talented. He's obviously talented, but he hasn't, like, put out albums.
He's just been focused on the TV stuff. But, dude, you know what I think about all the time? This goes past just music. This is, like, Twitter people, too. This is, like, anytime you want to make a name for yourself, it's almost easier if you're doing it as a moniker first. So this is, like... Zach Fox on Twitter's name was like Booty Math.
Yep.
Fucking old boy Rich Brian's name was Healy Riddler on Twitter. I was following him early on.
Yeah,
and he was
too.
Just a weird Twitter guy. And they built up their followings. And it's same with rappers. It's like, your name is The Weeknd or whatever. This is R&B singer. Or like, your name is fucking The Thing. And then once you like... Kid Cudi or whatever, but then once you start to be able to transfer over, you're like, I'm gonna go by my real name. You're like, I'm Jonnie Dumbfoundead Park now, you know.
Yeah.
And same with Zach Fox, same with whatever. It's like the people will follow you, but first they wanted to know you as this really simple, like very curated thing that's like, all I do is this thing.
Yeah.
Well, okay, for you then,
yeah,
if you got on those lists, would you want to be, what would you want to be listed as? Like, what name would you pick today if you got on a list?
It would probably be my real name, like Jonnie Park.
And you wouldn't even put Dumbfounded in there.
It would make
it. It's tricky because a lot of the credits I'm getting right now for acting, I put Jonnie Dumbfounded Park.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm also rethinking that now. I'm like, I have a chance to like come out the gates with like a whole new thing. Why not just like
Jonnie Park?
Do you think Anderson had a different name.
Was Booty
Breezy, Breezy Lovejoy.
Oh,
good change.
His name was Breezy Lovejoy. Is that his real name?
No, that was his artist name. That's not his real name.
I can't go by my birth given name.
When we were
Breezy Lovejoy.
So when we were making music hippie together, he used to go by Breezy Lovejoy. And I remember when he changed his name, he still had fans as Breezy Lovejoy.
Didn't he have like a name called like DJ or something?
What?
No.
Who was that?
You're talking about fucking DJ Khaled.
Was his name?
DJ Khaled's name.
No, the fuck out of it. Was it?
No, his name was something like...
Arab Attack.
Arab Attack. Yeah, that's what it was. And then
that's
after 9/11. And then he was... Bro. Because before that, it kind of made... He was like, the attack of the... We're attacking the beats.
I thought it was Anderson. No, Anderson was not... Yeah, Anderson was not DJ...
It was not even this... It was not the same guy. It was a DJ.
Yeah.
And also, it wasn't...
Right.
What is Anderson's DJ name?
Pee-wee.
DJ Pee-wee.
Yeah.
I think he should go back to Arab Attack. It'd be pretty sick.
Khaled?
Yeah.
You know, it'd be so sick is if Anderson gets on the list after your guys' movie comes out, after K-Pop's comes out, and he lists himself as Anderson DJ Pee-wee Bootytronic or whatever. What is his name? DJ
Breezy
Booty,
Lovejoy,
Breezy
man.
Lovejoy Breezy Anderson Love. Yeah. Pack.
I don't think he would have made it if his name was Breezy Lovejoy the whole time. People would have been like, this is too cool.
Okay, that's an interesting topic. Yeah. So do you think names matter? How much do you think names matter?
Yeah.
You think so?
Completely, yeah.
But there's rap names that would technically be considered sus if there wasn't the art attached to it sometimes.
Like, who are you talking about?
Like Fabulous.
What do you mean?
Fabulous is like...
But it's pronounced fabulous. If it was pronounced fabulous, then it would be like... But because it's fabulous,
fabulous,
it's dope. Yeah,
you think so? Okay.
Yeah, if it if his name, if he came out being like, "What's up, y'all? My name is Fabulous." You're like,
I think it depends because I think it's actually more simple than this. I think names matter on a simple basis of if you went by Arab Attack, it's not gonna work.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Fabulous, it's like there's nothing wrong with Fabulous.
No. I never even thought about that until I got older, right? Because the artist is so dope. I'm just like, whatever. I'll call you whatever. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, it just sounds like a regular name. Like, Ludacris sounds like a nickname if you really think about it. But, like, back then, it was just like, oh, it's just that's just his name, you know? Like, and I didn't think about it.
It's even cooler that his real name is Chris, so it's like...
Ludacris, yeah, exactly. Attached to
Whenever
it.
There's something that's, like, connected, like Kid Cudi, Scott Muscutty, like, that's cool.
Well, yeah, we go back to Donald. It's like Donald got his name from, like, a Wu-Tang, generator.
Yeah, the Wu-Tang name generator.
Yeah, and which
dude, no one would have thought that name would work. That name,
Childish Gambino.
Yeah. I remember first hearing that, and I was like, I love Donald Glover, and I was like, 20, 21, I was like, it's going to be pretty hard to break with. This is just a hard name to say.
Back then, it did sound a little weird and different. Like, my name sounds weird and different. Like, Dumbfounded is not, like a really rap-friendly name, to be honest.
But he, like, made it work by, like, having it in lyrics where he'd be like, Childish Gambino name, niggas never. And he was like, oh, he's it's the same way how, like, Aziz would put his name in a bunch of bits.
Yeah.
Where it'd be like, Aziz Ansari dies from, you know, and then.
He's, like, promoting it to be used, you're used to it already because I said, what's that thing of, like, he's airing his secrets out immediately.
Wow. Yeah.
So he's literally like, I got, him telling us he got it from a Wu-Tang name generator makes the lore okay.
Yeah.
That's true. A lot of artists, I mean, rappers obviously do that. Like mentioning themselves in like the third person or something, and there's comedians and people who always bring up their name. I notice I don't really do that a lot.
It's a branding tactic for sure. I think there's one bit I do right now, that one you saw me do about how like women are encouraged to be attracted to people they're fans of, but men aren't. And then I do that part where I say like Biniam Swift or whatever. But I have to do that more. I have to do it more. I'm literally, here's the name thing we're talking about. Legit, like yesterday, I was like, I should probably just go by Biniam. Because, like, you couldn't even say my name earlier, and you've known me for a while.
But you would go by just one name?
Nah, a little bit. More like if I'm doing something online, it might just say, like, with my first name. Because I just like, it's like, I don't care. It would depend on the place. But in the way, like, Aziz is just Aziz, it's like that. That's what I mean.
I think, yeah, I mean, it just, I guess it also depends on what your ultimate master plan is. Like, if you want to be easily Googleable and easily, like, we have a friend who's a great comic named Morgan J, but his real name is Morgan Vintasinque, and we would talk about this all the time where it was like, it was just hard for people to pronounce.
Yeah.
And I just, so he used his middle name.
Craziest names in Hollywood.
Dumbfounded.
That people pronounce
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah,
I mean, he's that's got crazy. Neger in his name. That's insane. Like, you don't even want to say it now. You're like Schwartz N word.
Arnold Schwartz N word, dude.
You like feel like you're like, can we not scared, say Schwartz?
Yeah, you better slow down before you jump into that one,
dude. Yeah. That name's crazy for so many reasons. Fucking Timothée Chalamet is actually pretty hard. Like
my mom calls him Timothée Champagne. It's so hard to say.
It is nice. It's pleasant once you get it, though. It Chalamet. Good. It's nice, you know?
I think my name sounds good if you learn it. Like Biniam Bizuneh. Sounds good.
It's not really hard. I think it's the alliteration that tricks me a little bit sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
You know, going from two B's, like Biniam.
But Timothée Chalamet all just rolls off the tongue. Mm-hmm. Benedict Cumberbatch. That's a hard one.
Yeah, that's true.
What I think a crazy name is Tom Cruise. Dude.
Like, it's like a parody of your own name.
Yeah. Your name is Tom Cruise?
Dude, you know what another crazy one is?
Insane. That's like if I came in here, I'm like, my name's Andy Fire.
Dude, here's the craziest one. Rip Torn
is crazy.
It's like they both mean the same thing, and it's like an adjective.
Rip Torn is a rap name.
Joaquin Phoenix is insane.
Oh, dude, that sounds fake, yeah.
Yeah, that's not...
But that's just hard, though.
Dude, also,
that's a hard-ass name.
You know who the black version of Rip Torn is? Tone Bell. That's like Tone Bell. What the hell? Yeah. That's like being named like Shoe Sneaker or something.
Yeah. Are you the most famous Andrew Lopez? Have you looked?
Oh, dude, this is my biggest fear of all time. It's I'm definitely in the running with lots of people who have like 7,000 followers on Twitter.
Dude,
like,
you're gonna pass
like,
all of them.
There's like a
you're
couple.
Pass them all.
There's like a journalist that writes for his hometown paper that's really close to beating me.
You're gonna pass them all in like 3 months already.
I disagree.
disagree. You don't think so?
I don't think so. You're tripping. I don't think so. Because I think, well, also fame is such a, I don't think fame exists in the way that we think that it exists anymore. It's like the matrix of, it's what's famous to whatever world
we
want.
Dude, it's crazy how many friends we've had. Because like when we first moved here, I met Andrew like over 10 years ago. We first moved here doing open mics. And we would see people on TV shows and be like, damn, this dude's, or someone would do Conan. Right. And be like, damn, they're famous, you know? And I can't tell you the number of friends we've had who've had their own TV show. They're starring in it. They still have 3,000 followers.
Yeah.
Nobody cares.
Well, here's the example.
That's a good point, yeah.
When you Google Andrew Lopez and I'm the first person to come up, 99% of people go, who the fuck is this guy about me? Do you know what I'm saying? Because
they're looking for that journalist.
Because they're looking for a different Andrew Lopez. They're looking at my credits being like, I haven't seen any of this
shit. They're just like I'm looking for the Mexican Andrew Lopez.
You know who the second most famous Andrew Lopez is?
Who?
Is a 19-year-old that got shot by the cops.
Really?
Yeah. So like, and I guarantee more people are looking for that.
Was it like a big story though? Or what?
Yeah, there's like ID Sundance documentaries about this dude.
Damn.
And people are like, get this fucking guy that's been on this show that I've never seen out of here. I'm looking for the dead guy.
Right, I'm looking for this cop murder.
Yeah, dude. And so that's why I think fame is just what's famous to you, and that's different for everyone.
Has anyone ever been trying to tag him and tag you? Been like, yo, prayers up for the Andrew Lopez.
I try to tag myself and shit. I actually tagged him because I think he's more famous.
Well, the annoying thing too, it's like, you know, there's people who are famous from different little pockets and niches, right? Like TikTok famous or Instagram famous, all that. And, you know, I was in that YouTuber world, you know? So when someone asked to take a picture with me, like in the middle of a fucking restaurant, like I'm already shy as hell and embarrassed that I stand up and we're taking a picture in front of all these people, and people around us are like, who the fuck is this guy?
And then they come over and be like, can I get a pic? And they do that thing where they go, who are you?
Like, like it would feel good if like people around you are like, oh, that's, you know, but most people aren't going to know who the fuck you are.
Yeah,
you
that's
know?
Funny. Well, I think this is why, because to be real, like I grew up like idolizing you. I think what's more interesting in today's culture than having fame is having legacy. And I think what you are known for and the longevity of known for that matters more than what you are in fame in the present. So like what you've done for Asian culture is the reason why people want to take pictures with you versus I saw your TikTok that I'm going to forget tomorrow is why I want to take a picture with you.
You mean something to them on this deeper level.
Yeah.
Like you almost represent something like, oh, I can fucking make a name for myself in whatever industry as a Korean that
bro, no, but you know what's annoying? It's like I'm still wanting relevancy, you know? Like because I've always been like, I've been putting out stuff every week for almost 20 years. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, what do you think is the most relevant thing you've ever done in your catalog?
Probably battle rap stuff.
Dude, I was going to say King of the Dot.
There's no other like stuff that battle rap because it's one area, not like everyone is in, you know what I mean? Like TikTok famous, I think everyone can kind of do something to get TikTok famous, but.
Well, I'll say it this way. It's the thing you were the best Asian at.
Yeah, that's why I think that's why I'm prideful of that because I'm like
no other.
There hasn't been a new Asian kid in it for like since I left, you know. Yeah. And I'm like, why isn't there? Like, there should be more Asian kids.
Can I ask
jumping
you a
medium
talk
it.
Question?
Yeah.
When people
what does
say
that mean when you say that, by the way, you've been saying that a lot today. And I'm like, what are you talking about?
That's like, he just starts picking up. He's like, this is nice.
Yeah. Medium talk, like it's not small talk.
Oh, dude, when you say medium,
like I'm talking to spirits and
shit.
But
here's the thing. When you say medium, I'm like, it's not deep either because it's halfway. That's what I think.
I'm not asking
medium
you.
Medium talk does sound wild as fuck.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
What?
When you say medium talk question, I'm like, look, it's not going to be small talk, but it's also not going to be that deep. It's just going to be in the middle.
It's right in the middle, bro. Okay. It's not icebreaker.
Okay.
And we aren't drowning yet.
Gotcha.
You know?
Okay.
Go medium talk.
Yeah.
Okay.
When people tell you things like, you were the best Asian at battle rap, is there a part of you that goes, it doesn't matter that I was Asian, I was good at it?
No, I used to care about that. You know, I used to care about being like, fuck that, I want to be the best. Like, especially when I was younger, you know?
Well, look, when I said that, I felt the tension. And
No. You did?
I felt did just really? Like, it was like, there wasn't a reaction to it. It was just like silence for a second.
Yeah.
Nah.
Yeah. Because, but the reason I said it is because
you're black.
Like, yeah, because I only see you guys as Asian. I see you as Asian.
That's why I'm asking you.
Then I see you as people.
Because the reason why I'm asking that, and I don't, and maybe I'm wrong about this, but when I think of MC Jin, all out of all the times he's on 106 in Park, they always have to bring up that he was the best Asian one, even though he was the best one that ever did 106 in Park. They don't call him the best battle rapper on 106 in Park when he was. They call him he was the best Asian one, like, because they only see him as the Asian guy. Well, look, around black
that's here's a better example, because that it's like he was clearly like the best in 106 in 100%. Park. You know, like everything else is like more like a little bit more subjective. There might be a gray area and stuff. But that clear, it's like super clear. Yes. You know?
Here's the reason I said it is because it's a super black thing. And it's like, not only is there not any, there's not white people, whatever. There's like, you're the only one who looks different out of all the people there. So of course that's going to make you stand out, but then you were good on top of it. So like, it's a thing. It's the same reason why like Tiger Woods was amazing and the best, but it was like, he's the only black guy out here doing this. And that was like another point of like, you know, it's a selling point.
When it comes,
do you call Tiger Woods the best golfer or do you call Tiger Woods the best black golfer?
Both.
But you didn't do that to him.
Well,
but I don't know. I don't think, do you consider yourself the best ever battle rapper?
No, here. Let me answer this. Mm-hmm. This is actually a really good question. And the reason that I don't mind it now is because with art, right? Art is subjective. It's hard to be like, who's the best and who's the worst. So if you're like, who's the best? You're the best Asian battle rapper. It's like more specific and I can take that title. Like, I feel more comfortable being like, I'll take that title.
I heard Neil Brennan talk about this with comedy. Yeah. So you know how Neil Brennan does these like one-man shows when he does his stand-up? Have you ever seen any of his things? Like, one's called Three Mics. The other one's called Blocks.
Yep.
And he talked about the reason why he started doing these like one-man show things was, I think Hassan said it too. It was on the podcast. I don't remember which one of them said it, but they do both do the same kind of thing. He was like, I think I can be the best or near the top at this way of doing stand-up.
Yeah.
If I'm just trying to be Bill Burr, I'm never going to be Bill Burr.
Oh,
but like, they were like, the more specific I am, the more I stand out. And I'm like, that's dope. That's not a bad thing, I think.
I don't think it's a bad thing. And also, here's another point. When people see me on stage, or even you, they're going to see an Asian dude up there. Mm-hmm. Like, you can't run away from that. Like, as much as we're like, no, we're just a human up on stage, the first thing, even before a joke comes out of your mouth, is like, Asian.
That's why we were talking about earlier. You don't need to say I'm Asian. They already know.
I'm already here,
That's what I'm saying.
I'm Asian.
But it's going to be a big part of your identity no matter what. So people are going to say you're the best Asian in this and that. Like, it's a clear part of your identity, you know? I don't think that's going to change anytime soon, you know?
Andrew was the best Asian on the Variety's 2023 writers.
I don't even think that's true.
Were you the only Asian on there?
At this point in time in this world, everyone looks Asian to me.
Dude, no, don't give me the real answer. I think so. I feel like everyone else was.
And that's a situation you'll stand out and people will pay attention to more if you were the only
But
Asian
you also
on that
are
list.
Like good too. It's but you
guys, I'm gonna be honest, I don't care anymore. I don't like I just really hate this talk because I think that like I feel tension right now because I don't care. I don't even know who on that list is what.
Yeah.
I literally do not care. Like, I'm on a list of screenwriters, and that's what I know I'm on a list on. So, like, I think that, like, when people go, like, are you the only Asian on the list? I'm like, I have no fucking idea.
But is your idea of, like, fame differ from as a writer and as an actor? Like, as an actor, you want to be, like, seen and famous.
No. At this point in my life, no. I think that, like, I want to be authentic. And I think that that's a douchey thing to say, but like, I don't want to be famous for something that I'm not.
Yeah, you want to be on cool shit.
No, not even that.
Then what is it exactly?
I'll do anything. I'll do Good Booger 3. I don't give a fuck.
Then what do you mean authentic coming from what?
I
want to
be
angle?
An actor and I want to be famous if I ever get famous, which I will or not, I don't know. But like, it's something I wanted to do.
Yeah.
Like, even if it's on something bad, but I'm acting in it, I did it. I got to be an actor.
You like just the fact that you were given that opportunity.
Yeah, I just want to be me.
And which is like, already rare for so many people to be on like a TV show or a movie.
Yeah, so if somebody puts me on a list as a writer and I actually tried to be a writer, whether I make a movie or not, maybe one day I never will. That's totally possible. I'm not a good writer in my eyes. I work hard, but I think that like somebody saw me as a writer and that's all I need. Like I don't need it to be a good, I could write Good Burger 3 tomorrow and like if it's bad, I did it.
That's
and
true.
That's it. That's all I want to be known as. Like, and I think that, and then I also want to be known as a dad someday. I want to be known as a comic. I want to be known as a good friend. And that's all it is. Like, I, anytime anybody tells me I want to be in good shit, it's what you said. It's so subjective that, like, what makes that better than something else?
All you can really know is, like, what you did on it. And, like, did you, like, give it the quality of your, like, effort? Yeah. And then you, like, it's hard to control after
that. I think I've broken through that barrier of, like, being scared to put anything out. Yeah. Like, I'm over that. I don't have that. Most people have that, right? Yeah, like, they never put anything out because they're scared of the reviews, the outcome of the integrity of how that art is put out.
Do you think that you felt that way only because you put something out? Have you ever put something out that people didn't like and that made you feel better about putting things out?
I think it slowly happened because I was putting out so much content every week. I just realized you can't make everyone happy anyways.
Yeah.
There's always shitty comments and stuff. And I was like, oh, this is just how it is.
Do you feel
like,
immune to it now?
I am super immune to it. But I was always kind of like that when I was young. Like, I'd draw like a shitty painting or something and I'd be like, I'd always wanted to show it to people and does, shit. Like,
does any like stuff hurt your? Is there like
I fuck with that?
I just loved sharing my shit. Yeah. I was like, look, I did this.
I love that. You know, like, but dude, that's what's awesome about that is that like you're literally saying. I'm sorry that I interrupted you, but I think that like that is beautiful to me. Is this idea that you going back to this childlike sense of creating?
I do have
like,
that. Yeah,
that's amazing.
I always have that. Like, I make art because I do want to share it with people. I'm not just like insular and just like,
yes, bro.
And yes, so it's for me too, but really the ultimate like final level of my art is for people.
Bro, I love I think that there's a situation, like I literally feel what you're saying in this room. This feels like young you is proud of yourself being in this room. And that's why this feels so dope. When people ask me about the Asian thing or what you want to be famous for this Asian or like, what are you the only Asian screen? Like, do you know those things? When I was 5 years old coloring, I wasn't like, shit, I bet I'm the only Asian person in the class coloring like this. Mm. No, I was just coloring. And that's all I want to share. And like, if I can get back to that feeling.
That's true, yeah.
That's what I want
to
do.
That's what we're all trying to do, I think, is get back to like that innocence, you know, that we've all had, and that purity we all had.
Bro, we talk about this all the time. I think the only reason why we stayed in stand-up so long is because we were so ignorantly innocent when we moved here.
Yeah.
That like we were saying crazy shit. We would go up to people we are fans of, like whether it was like as an example, like Donald or Aziz, and we'd be like, I love you, bro. Will you come do my open mic? Because we were so childlike in this situation. And that little bit of ignorance and childlike, you know, dumbness brought us here.
It helps you like do things that once you know too much, you start to be like, I don't want to do that because I don't want to be seen that way, because you have like the awareness of how you might be perceived. Yeah. And that is a killer. It's the thing you were talking about before, people being scared to put anything out. That's why I'm so glad I started doing things young, because there's no way I could ever start doing shit now. Can you imagine being 33 and being like, I'm going to go do an open mic? And bro, for the first time.
It's tough.
I still have shame, but I have like way less shame about certain like type of sharing art. And I feel no fear of like, oh, I gotta go do this random show or whatever. I'm just like, I know I can do it because I did it for so many years.
I don't think it's just a shame either. It's like energy, you know? And I'm not talking about like, you're just physical, like, oh, I'm sleepy or this. It's the overall energy of seeing it like longevity. Like I gotta do this every day for the next year or multiple years. Yeah. Like we don't have that energy like we used to, but although I'll see someone like Ridley Scott making movies and I'm like, what the fuck?
Bro,
I mean,
that's like 90.
That's crazy.
He's making war epics, bro.
He made a movie that was like 3 hours and 30 minutes. I was like, bro, long were you up that day? You're 90.
Do you guys ever think this? Because I was like the doing things early on that you maybe didn't have, like you didn't have the awareness, you were innocent, like you were saying. I am so thankful to my younger self often. I like think of like, man, I'm so glad he did that thing because I couldn't do that now. That's a snapshot of-
Do you actually think that though? Because I think that I like the first half of that sentence, but I have to challenge you though. Like, let's go back to that open mic, the 33-year-old doing an open mic. I actually think that's fucking fire, dude.
I think that's great. I'm just like, saying I don't know that I could.
But I think you could. Literally, like- I bet a year from now you're gonna do something, because the first time you do something, that is the childlike sense of innocence, right? Is that like 5 years from now, I don't know how to skateboard, but 5 years from now, I could pick up a skateboard at 37 and start skateboarding. And the thing about that is like,
here's
where I'm glad I did it at 37 point. Right. Because it's the first time I did it.
I'm not saying it's impossible. I'm not saying like it can't be done. But I think every single year we grow a little more conservative in our like choices. We grow a little bit more like, oh, this is who I am. I don't know if I'm going to try this thing. And I hear it from people that I know where they're like, oh man, I always wish I started stand up, or I always wish I did. And they feel like they can't start it now.
Yeah.
And like some people are fucking brave enough and crazy enough to be like, I don't give a fuck. I'm 37. I'm going to do my first ever. But that is like a rare person.
You know, I think it is too. It's like, I think if I were to be honest, you're right. And I think the older we get, the more realistic we get. You have to be more realistic. Like, do I have time to do it as opposed to can I do it?
And I think because when we were like fucking 18, 19 and we were doing stand up in college or whatever, it's like, that gives you the momentum, like you're saying, the energy to like do other things. So like, I feel, I don't think I'm going to do this, but let's say I was like next year, I was like, you know what? I'm going to do a rap album. It would be really scary, but because I've been doing stand up and acting and writing and doing all this stuff that feels risky in some other way, it'd be easier to do that.
Yeah, I agree.
Versus someone who never did, because you do like every art form. You rap, you act, I think comedy.
What I do, all those things make sense with each other, but like imagining a insurance salesman or something who's been in insurance for 10 years, all of a sudden being like, I want to try stand up. That's pretty bold, you know, just seeing that jump.
Yeah.
You were on stages for years and years and years. So when you first did stand up, did it feel that scary to you?
It wasn't as scary, I'll admit, because I'm coming from battle rap and things. It feels somewhat scarier. Like stand-up sometimes, you know?
But to that same point, like, who's one of your favorite battle rap artists?
Hollow to Don.
Okay, so Hollow to Don called you tomorrow and goes, hey, I'm going to try stand-up for the first time. And then an insurance agent that works on Wilshire that you've never met goes, hey, I'm going to try stand-up for the first time tomorrow. Which show are you going to? I'm going to go to the insurance agent's show.
That's a good point. Yeah.
Because I'll be like, that sounds hilarious.
I
want to see what this guy's going to fucking do.
Dude, I would go to, if I was a fan of Hollow to Don and I'm like, this is, and I know him, I would totally go to the guy that I'm just like, what's this guy going to do? Because like, I'm thinking of like the opposite is like, we know Nate Bargatze or something. If Nate Bargatze was like, hey, I'm going to do a rap show. I'm like, what is Nate Bargatze gonna do with this rap show versus Stranger?
No, but here's the difference. If Nate Bargatze goes, I'm gonna do a rap show, and Ridley Scott goes, I'm gonna do a rap show, I'm going to Ridley Scott's rap show.
For sure.
Because I'm going to the one that's not the closest thing.
The furthest away. Yeah,
I hear what you're saying. And I would go to that too, because I'm just like, that's crazy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But
Hollow to Don, you're going to be like, he's going to be okay at it.
But also, do you want to hear like Jeremy Renner's country album? I don't know.
Yeah, hell yeah, bro.
Have you heard it already?
Dude, I think you have. Yeah, it sounds like the Chainsmokers. Okay, well,
I have a question about this. Yeah. And I bet you have a theory about it. Or maybe you do too, because you've done it. Why is it that so many musicians, whatever genre, it could be rapper, there's a lot of rappers, but there's other people from other genres, there's Justin Timberlake, where if you were a musician first and made it big as that, you can transition into acting pretty, it's not easy, but you can get a movie or two. But the other way around, like you were a big actor and now you're gonna do music, barely anyone gives a fuck and they don't look at it, you know?
I have a theory on it.
Yeah.
I think it's because going into the music, you're focused on the person before the music. And I think that when it comes from music first, they have to prove this musical art form that has longevity and replay value.
Yeah.
And then I want the next thing outside of the person.
Yeah.
But when it's like Johnny Depp going to play guitar, I want to see Johnny Depp more than I want to see the music. So I'm not even really focusing on what that
is. It feels
music
novelty.
Is. Yes.
Like, right?
It also feels like your side hustle.
Yeah. I will say, I think the two hardest entertainment gigs is stand-up comic and popping off as a musician. Those two. Like popping off as a comic and popping off as a musician. Mm. Comic, I don't know. They're both extremely hard. Like it's like less than 1% to make that happen.
In the trenches, which one did you have more fun in? Being a trenches as a musician or being in the trenches as a comic?
Music was just like, it just happened so naturally. I wasn't chasing money at all for it. I'm not with being a comic either. Like, I make money other ways, and I've still been going up, you know, on mics and stuff. Yeah. And that's been hard because I'm 37 years old. And
dude,
just,
you're the 37-year-old.
Yeah, I am, in a way. But it's harder for me. Like, I could be going up to more mics per week, but it
bro,
is
bro, you're 37. You look good, dude.
Thanks, fucking man. Good thanks, skin. Yeah, what do you bro. Use, dude? Yeah, do you use dude. Human
You just take a shit in my bathroom. You just
did,
look at dude. The products, bro.
Do you use the Pharrell shit?
Yeah, he's got nice stuff. Byredo's in there, dude.
You have, like, a 12-step Korean skincare shit?
I don't, but I did buy some expensive shit, yeah.
What's the brand?
Like, I went for one, like, facial, and I just asked, like, yo, what's the joint? I just bought it all.
Do you think you're hotter now than you were when you were a kid?
I was a ratty, greasy some kid. I don't know if I was movies. If I'm hotter because you know what's funny? I was just talking with my friends about this. Mm-hmm. Like when we were I was roommates with all of like Anderson's band, you know, with mm-hmm. Anderson too, all that. Besides Anderson, because he's like a full on rock star, you know.
Is his real name Anderson Pack?
Or is it's parts of his name. His real name's Brandon. Brandon and Pack Anderson.
That's why he went by Breezy, because Brandon.
Yeah, Brandon.
Wow.
Yeah.
Man, he has some good branding changes, you know?
Okay, so...
Brandon Pack Anderson is his name?
Yeah.
That's a shitty name.
Anderson Pack, we love you.
Yeah, I'm joking.
But here, I'm joking. So here's what I'm saying.
Sounds like a fake name. What's Brandon your name? Pack, Brandon Pack Anderson.
It looks like a guy who's trying to like show, it's like... Yeah. Anderson? Yeah.
That's well, okay, here's what I'm saying.
Sounds like a guy lying about his ethnicity.
Dude, he switched around the order.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's
it's
cool.
Like, yeah.
I would never think
Anderson,
to do that.
Whoa.
Because if you were just like Lopez Andrew. You know?
I will say there's...
Wait, what's your middle name? Brian?
Brian, dude.
So Lopez Brian?
Middle name Brian's kind of wild too, though.
Oh, yeah, sure, dude. Brian.
Oh,
dude.
My middle name's crazy.
What is it?
Edgar.
Dude, that's why you're Chino. That's why you got the fucking button up on right now.
I know. My middle name's Edgar.
Johnny Edgar Park?
Yes.
That's a fucking Scorsese movie, dude.
Johnny Edgar Park.
That's Infernal Affairs.
Dude, hey, Edgar Wright.
Dude.
Edgar Wright.
Dude, fuck this Johnny Dumbfoundead part. Johnny Edgar Park. That should be your acting name.
That's a sick
name, cool.
Dude.
My writer name should have been Edgar Wright.
Oh,
Edgar or my Park? Rap name should have been Edgar Wright.
Oh, you spell it like
Wright.
Okay,
dude.
Edgar Park is dope, too.
I don't know.
I don't think I'd be your fan if you were Edgar Wright.
That's why I didn't go with it.
None of the rappers know who Edgar Wright is, so like nobody would get that it's like a pun on Edgar Wright.
That's why Edgar was hard. Like, I don't think all my girl fans would have been like lusting over an Edgar. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like maybe in like the 19th century or something.
Edgar Park does sound like a cool name for like a production company or for like an actual park. Like, hey, bro, let's meet at Edgar Park.
Edgar Park.
Yeah.
Hey, fool. Let's meet at Edgar Park. Okay, let me finish my thought. So I was talking to my friends who we all came up as struggling musicians. Now everyone's successful. Mm. They all made a good living for us. But we were all roommates back in the day. And when we were broke, we would get way more girls then. You know, I think and we were talking about why that was. And because at the time we had to like really work to get girls, you know, we had to be out trying to really finesse and all that.
Hollering.
Now that we're more successful, I think we want that process to be a lot easier. Like we want it to be handed to us, but we're not at the level of like Anderson to get it handed to you, like a rock star status. So we're
and
stuck
the right
in this
bar. I feel like you are.
Yeah, in the right bar. You're right.
There's places I've walked in with you where it's like, you're the king of the club, you know?
The king of the club. That sounds sad as fuck.
Oh, shit, Edgar.
King of the
dude,
club.
Dude, Edgar Park is here.
Oh, shit, EP, fucking, dude.
Hey, we got a table for you.
That'd be unfortunate if the great Korean hope had to be Edgar Park.
Edgar Park, dude. Yeah, that dude definitely owns Cafe Blue.
Yeah.
But here's the question about that, too, is that... like it goes back to the risk factor of the childlike thing.
Yeah.
Because I think that like we were talking about this earlier where like if when I was broke or when, you know, I didn't have anything to lose, I took more risks.
Yeah.
So I would go up and get shot down more because I was like, I know I'm a loser.
Yeah.
But now it's like this thing of not that I think I'm great, but I don't want to like get canceled or I don't want to offend somebody I have, you know, I'm still thinking about my ex that I've had a relationship with. Mm-hmm, there's all these feelings.
So
now,
you think as a public figure or someone with a name, it's just like, you just got to cool it all around?
Well, no, I don't even know. Cause I don't think I'm a public figure. I think it's my ego.
Yeah.
It's, I don't want to set myself back because I have such an inflated ego after time.
I see what you're saying.
That that's why I think ego death is always important to have. And that's where those, that's why I would go to that insurance person's stand-up show, because as opposed to like somebody that's already been around the business and being like, I'm going to try to transition into rap, that's not really an ego death to me. But if an insurance agent has kids and stuff and they're like, I'm going to go try stand-up, they've had some sort of ego death recently.
Right.
That there was a restart there that I think we need to respect.
Okay. Yeah. Here's the
and
thing,
and that's
I'll
where
say.
Going back, like, I haven't had an ego death.
And the material might be better too because
well,
of that ego
yes,
death.
Here's
right?
the thing.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I agree that if that person wrote honest material, it might be more interesting. Mm-hmm. But I think, what was his name? OJ the Juice Man?
Yeah,
what was
his name? Yeah. Wait, his name is OJ the Juice Man?
No, no, no. Juice Man.
No, no. what was the name of that rapper you said? That's not, I just said OJ the Juice Man.
What
your
rapper?
Favorite battle rapper. That
Hollow to Don.
Hollow to Don?
By the way, OJ the Juice Man was the only one, only freshman on that year of the list who didn't kind of pop off.
Yeah, no one knows where OJ the
because that I think that's
can't
the
even
same
say it. OJ the Juice Man.
I think that list had like J. Cole, Drake, Kendrick, Big Sean, Kent,
yeah,
like,
oh shit.
And it was like one or two guys
dude,
that didn't blow.
You know
that
why
must
he
feel
didn't? Name was bad, bro.
OJ the Juice Man.
OJ the Juice Man might as well be Breezy Lovejoy. Yeah. It's terrible.
Yeah, so you say, so that case, you're saying that case yeah. names do matter.
It yeah. does, dude.
Because I can't even say it.
Yeah,
OJ the Juice Man.
What's
duh.
The worst rap name in the game right
dude,
now besides
that motherfucking exquisite?
Dude, I don't want to say it, but you know it. The guy who had, we were talking about this.
Oh.
Can you tell the anecdote about this guy? Yes, that
yes.
guy.
This is how you know that people don't give a shit about Asian racism.
Because he wanted his shit to be like more
yeah.
marketable.
Yeah, so Chinx Drugs is a rapper, and yep. he goes, yo, I can't make it with the name Chinx Drugs. People are going to cancel this shit. So I need to be more marketable. I'm going to, you know, move on to the mainstream. So he drops the offending part of his name, and he just goes by Chinx. This motherfucker goes, yeah, my name's Chinx Drugs, but I don't want to offend y'all, so I'm dropping drugs.
He's like, there's no way I can be a Walmart if my name... Dude, and then remember we were playing Quiplash?
Bro, we were playing Quiplash. You know the game Quiplash? This is a game made like for families.
Super huge game. We're playing Quiplash 3, the most recent one that came out in 2020.
Bro, we're playing Quiplash.
And you try to make your name Dane Coon.
We're just making funny names. I'm like, I love Dane Cook. That's a true thing.
Yeah.
So I'm going to name my character Dane Coon.
Yeah, and all our names were terrible stuff like that. Yeah. Like, it was all, like, puns. And like, so, I had, like, Harvey Weinstein. You know, shit like that.
So I put in Dane Coon, and then Quiplash goes, bonk, offensive name.
Wow. And then I was like, I was like, okay, maybe they just have this. Let's try Dane Nigga. So then type that in. Mm-hmm. Doesn't work.
Go
then
bonk,
I'm like, then I'm
offensive.
Like, let's try hard R. Tries that. Yeah. Still doesn't
bonk,
work.
Offensive.
Then I'm like, why don't you try drugs?
So I go, Dane Chinx. Let's go. The game goes great. That's better.
You win. Yeah. But like, it didn't care.
The fucking censorship
thing was like, that's fine.
Well, it's another word.
This
it's
is
another
how
meaning
you know it,
too, though, right?
But this is how you know.
Oh, because in the armor?
Armor. Chink into armor.
I guess, but there was never...
With Coon.
Yeah.
Yeah, but here's the thing.
Hold on. You know how you're censoring yourself right now?
Yeah.
People say chink. They don't say the N word, but they say chink to describe that it's an offensive word.
Yes, you've heard me say.
But
I'm just not saying
and
it.
Just so you know,
I respect that because I've never heard the censoring of the chink, even when you're talking about how offensive.
Bro,
it
this is a post-Shane Gillis society, all right?
Hey, bro, he's saying chink with a hard K, bro. This shit is crazy.
Like it's clinking.
Yeah,
the chink is clinking.
There's a chink in the armor, bro.
I think I'm raising it to the level of the N word in that, like, I'm not going to say it. Okay.
Here's how you know that we don't give a fuck about Asian racism is that I'm saying chink and I ain't even Chinese, bro.
Right.
That's what's also
crazy. No, but chink transcends into all Asians, I think.
You think so?
Yeah, of course, bro. I mean, I've been
called... Because the racist wouldn't be like, oh shit, you're Filipino? My bad. I'll call you whatever.
Because Asians have their, like, we have an individual, right? Gook is Korean.
Mm-hmm.
But like, Gook doesn't really hit. Like, chink hits, so they use chink on all the Asians. Mm.
What do I agree?
That is worse than...
Gook does not hit. To me. Gook does not hit. It's funny.
Look,
but Gook is funny. Gook is funny as fuck.
Gook does not hit. It's funny.
It ain't hit the same.
Yeah.
It's built different, bro.
If like a young person called me a gook, I'd be like, how old are you? Like, are you a time-traveling racist?
But here's the thing about Asians, though, that I think that's a testament to Asians. I actually think that Asians are so dope that we openly take back things because they're like, all right, call me that shit. I don't give a fuck. Because shout out to our boy Justin Chong. This motherfucker takes that and goes, I'm gonna make it art, bro. I love that shit. Like that's
some... Oh, you're talking about the movie Gook.
Yeah.
I kept just thinking of Chink. I was like, did he name a movie Chink?
Dude, that's how you know it's crazy. That's how you know it's worse, is that you would be like, what the hell? You can't name a movie that. You didn't even remember that he had a movie. Yeah.
You know? Yeah. Okay, I just thought of a fire ass Asian rapper name would be Chink. Like but CH.Inc.
Oh, bro, you're bad at this, bro.
No, I think that's bad. I think that's bad.
Never mind. Right? Okay, for a second, I thought that was fire.
Did you come up with Breezy Lovejoy, too?
Anderson, I got a name for you, bro.
Okay.
But you know what? The funny thing is, he right when he changed it is when he blew up.
Dude.
When he changed it.
Didn't he have a name that was like Boobies or something?
No.
Dude, wait, I think his name, no, before it was Arab Attack.
isn't there a rapper that went by like Booby Love Guy or something?
I never heard of that.
You're talking about 2 Chainz.
Oh,
Titty
2
Boy, Titty Boy,
Titty Boy. Oh. 2 Chainz was Titty Boy. Yeah. He changed it to 2 Chainz.
But you know, he did it too early because there. I mean, but honestly, for longevity, 2 Chainz is great.
Titty Boy's like internet-y.
There was like a world. There was like Ugly Mane and
shit.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
There was like a time when that was like, oh, that's a good name
for sure. Titty Boy.
But then I think it went away. It's not good anymore. Mm-hmm. Like I haven't heard of Ugly Mane for a long time.
Well, I think you also look at like longevity. Like if Drake is gonna feature somebody named Titty Boy, like Drake isn't gonna want to put featuring Titty Boy.
Okay, what's the worst name of the most popular person? Maybe XXXTentacion. That's a pretty a hard name to say. You look at it, you're like, what is
he
this?
Made it work though, because you know he was huge.
Well, because people shortened it to X, so that was like how you could
But there was already an X too. There was DMX. And he was huge.
Maybe he was just good enough.
Yeah,
but like it's not like, do you think it was a good name?
XXXTentacion. I don't even know
you what to like, say yeah. it yeah mm. We would be talking about him and we would always say something different. We'd be like extension cord or whatever the fuck.
I think the worst name for somebody that's popular is Chinks.
Chinks, like, he's dead now. Drugs. He's dead.
Is he dead?
He's dead.
Yeah, he passed. Rest in peace, Chinks Drugs. No, but Chinks Drugs is a wild name.
That's pretty bad.
That's a wild name.
He never broke into the mainstream, though, so he's definitely not the most popular one.
Yeah.
Well, if you're an Asian rapper, though, Chinks Drugs is a hard-ass name.
That is. See, that's what's cool about it.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
If you were an Asian rapper, though, that'd be a hard name.
Well, okay. I honestly thought that Rich Chigga was a good name. I liked it.
Okay, well, we got one.
He changed it because, like, black people wouldn't like it or something.
Well, yeah. I mean, why wouldn't you change it?
Because I get it.
Yeah.
But hearing it, I wasn't offended. I was like, because he was an internet guy.
I knew a lot of black friends who weren't also offended by the name too.
But he was trying to get to the mainstream. Drake's not going to be like Drake featuring Rich Chigga.
Right. You bring on a whole lot of problems that you don't want to deal with.
I also wonder too, like, with the idea of the name changes, has there ever one that went the wrong way?
Like, oh, well, I mean, there's all the ones with like Diddy where he did name changes and no one listened. Where
Diddy worked though.
Yeah. Diddy worked, but then he was like Love and then no one went along with the Love one. Everyone was just like, you're Diddy.
But that, at that point, it felt like a bit too.
Do you remember Snoop Dogg did it? He was like, Snoop Lion. And everyone was like, okay, whatever. That's a Halloween costume, bro.
Shut the fuck up, Snoop Dogg.
We're not listening to this. And he was like, okay, I'm just Snoop Dogg.
Oh, Meta World Peace.
Actually worked. I feel like people call him Meta.
Bro, I saw Meta World Peace on an airplane. Dude, this dude gets on an airplane. He sits in the row in front of me, exit row.
Mm-hmm.
He's there with, I don't know if it's his wife, his girlfriend. I don't know. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
But he's there with somebody. And this dude cuddling up with her, sleeping. I was like, this motherfucker Meta World Peace
right now, bro. He's living the day.
Yeah,
no, I've met him before. He was actually really nice. He's a really sweet guy.
People from Indiana still call him Ron Artest because that's what he was when he was there. Like, he's still Ron Artest. I think a lot of people still call him Ron Artest.
Ron Artest is a good name,
but Meta
too, actually.
It matched him.
It did.
Like, it was like, Ron Artest felt like he was like, it felt like a hard-ass name.
Yeah,
like,
Artest.
It was like, oh, shit.
Yeah. I mean, name changes is tough. I've gone through several name changes.
Dude, I didn't name change.
Oh, yeah.
I used to be Ben Bizuneh.
Oh,
up until I was 27. And then I did my Barry to Barack and was like, I'm going to do my African name. But it wasn't even about like, My parents still call me Ben. You still call me Ben, which is fine. Bro, like my
married a Barack. I didn't even realize that.
Dude, he did it. Barack Obama, the most famous name change of all time. He knew he was trying to. He's like, you know what? Mm-hmm. In 20 years, when I run for president, this Barack is going to hit.
It's crazy that his middle name is Saddam.
It's Hussein.
That was close though, but
Barry Saddam Obama, dude.
Yeah, well, I gotta say though, he had a vision because technically that wouldn't be the that
dude,
wouldn't
that
be
that was a joke, right? Shut up.
I didn't think about the Barry to Barack thing too.
Dude,
I didn't
his
know
middle
that
his name was Osama. Yo, his Barack name was Barack Osama, Osama Obama.
Yo, did the name change from Barry?
It's crazy that our 46th president was named Osama Obama. Yo, show me that birth certificate.
I will say when Obama
shout
came
out higher
out,
ground,
a lot of people were probably thinking
they were
Osama,
like, "This dude's
right?
Yeah, I mean, that was his whole. That's why people were saying
his
it's
middle
like,
name was Hussein.
Dude,
right?
That's so the craziest part of him being president. It was that people like we had elected a dude whose name rhymes with the guy who committed the worst terrorist attack ever.
Right, right.
It would be like if a president's name was like John Bitler, and it's like a little too close to Hitler, you know?
That's so true. You know?
That's crazy.
John Bitler.
Bitler. Who's running for president? Arnold Schwarzenegger and John Bitler.
Arnold Schwarzenegger N-word and John Bitler.
Yo, imagine Arnold dropped Schwartz because he was like, this is way too long.
Dude, if he was running for governor in like 2020, he would have dropped it. So like, I'm just
Schwartz.
Yeah, and then they're like, is he Jewish? It's like, nah, he just...
We got to drop...
Yeah.
Dude, if his name was that and then he went by the Terminator, bro.
Oh my God.
That's hard.
There's
dude.
So many unfortunate
But the reason I went through
that.
So you're doing name change stuff. The reason I changed mine was like, if I was going to be publicly like, you know, named or whatever, like credited, I just wanted it to be like the name I was given so that people like, I just wanted to just be like, I'm proud of my name. This is what my name. I didn't want to be like, I had to shorten it because that sounds easier, you know? And it, there is, the downside is like, every time someone's introduced me at a comedy show, they're always like, Biniam, like they don't know. Yeah. It's like a little too much for them.
The amount of times I've seen people at a comedy show be like, this guy's funny. You've seen, I love his stuff. I watch. He's my best friend. Give it up for Biniam.
Give it up for Beady Man Tuna. Give it up for Bazooka Bizooka.
Hey, Biniam is a hard name.
Biniam is, I
that's
like
a
my
hard
name.
Ass
I
name.
Like my name too. But in but like I don't really care with like what my friends call like all my mom dude this is hilarious that like I told my dad that I changed I was like you know I'm going by Biniam like crediting wise like for writing credits and for whatever and he was like that's good Ben.
That's good, Ben.
he called
I'm
me.
I'm going by the name you gave me, Dad. Yeah, yeah. I'm going by Biniam.
Okay, Ben, if that makes you happy, yeah.
But a lot of rappers started doing that thing where they wanted to go by their real names. You know, Kendrick kind of, you know, he was K Dot, and he went to Kendrick Lamar.
I thought that was just a nickname. I didn't know.
Yeah,
that.
Even J Cole, like you know, all these people started going by their real names. That became a trend.
What was J Cole's change?
No, he was just Jesus J. Cole.
But people...
But
people
Jermaine Cole, you know.
Jermaine Cole. Gotcha. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then I guess like when people become actors, they start to do their real name where it'll be like Curtis 50 Cent Jackson, Scott Kid... Well, his just says Scott Mascuddy because Cuddy's already in there. He doesn't even put like, Scott Kid
Chris Ludacris Bridges.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And now you're doing Johnny Dumbfoundead Park, but I do think it should be Johnny Edgar Park.
Yeah.
Nah, I'm not doing that.
Bro. Johnny Eddie Park.
Dude, I think it would be good for your Latino audience to be like, oh, maybe he's like half Mexican too.
Edgar.
Dude, by like 2030, by 2030, I think Latinos are going to overtake white people in the population or something.
Is that true?
No, I don't know. It's something like that.
Do people question you about Lopez?
Yeah.
Dude, today. Dude, today.
2 hours ago,
dude,
we were hanging out.
Fucking today, this girl who's Korean, she was like, are you Asian?
Yeah, after we had an hour conversation, she goes, so are you Asian?
And I was like, what do you think he was? And she was like, maybe because your last name, you're like mixed with Latino. And I'm like, do you not know about Filipino? She was like, I honestly don't know many Filipinos.
Well, I'm like, what do I look like? And she goes like, you look like half, you know, like, and I go like, do I look half white? And she goes,
no. It was a very like, in your dreams.
Yeah. You wish.
In your dreams, Tony? No.
Yeah.
Are you Asian? No, but I'm half. Half what? Do I look half white? I'm sorry, but you look Asian.
She's like, no, thank you.
I've heard that tone too. Yeah. It sucks.
Yeah. But yeah, people think I'm, but honestly, like it's one of those things too, where I think that like, honestly, it's been something that makes me be able to be myself more. Because if people get to ask me, then I get to talk about me. And like, I get to set the record straight. I think that there's this, because I grew up in Iowa, the greatest place on earth to me. And I like, and I grew up in a place that was so supportive that I'm under the thing of like, if I'm the first one you've ever met, I have no, I'm not going to put on to you that you're supposed to know and respect me. You don't know me. So it's like, it's my job to educate and then they learn. So like, if they're like, what are you? I'm like, I'm Filipino. And they're like, you're the first Filipino. I'm like, fucking, you met the best one then. Yeah. Like, great.
I think that's, like, and you live by that. I've seen you do that so many times because it's like the second you go like, how dare, it's like, fuck it.
Who cares?
Then they're going to be like, dude, Filipinos suck.
Yeah. That's
no,
not why I'm single.
No, I agree with you on that because I feel like we get that a lot as a conversation of like, you know, with Asians and us standing up for ourselves happens a lot. I kind of feel like we got to be able to hang with everyone else when it comes to things like roasting or taking a joke. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, you're the king of that. You got that shit all the time in your art form.
Yeah, and a lot of Asian comics are the same way, right? Because we live by the funny. Like, we want to be funny and we want to be able to joke around and hang with everybody and not be so sensitive to things. Like, we got to make everyone in the community feel that way so we can just, everyone can roast each other. Because what I've learned in battle rap is like, you can get it for whatever reason. You know, because people comment under my battles, all these Asians get angry and they start defending me under the battles. But I'm like, I've battled an Asian person and
have you
only used Asian jokes. You know what I mean? Like,
when you when you would go up against a black dude and you know that they're going to say the most racist Asian shit, like small dick, this and fucking you own a laundry, whatever the fuck they're going to say. Would you be like, I'm going to say the racist black shit back to them. I'm going to be like, you don't go to college. You don't know your dad.
Nah, because even if I use racial jokes, right? Like against a Latino or whatever, I use different angles. Like, I've battled a Latino dude, and when I battled the Latino dude, my angle was like, I'm more Latino than you. You're like a whitewashed Latino. To me, that makes people like you more.
But how about with black dudes, though? You would never
I focus on physical features.
So you would be like,
big motherfucker.
This nigga's lips so big.
You know what? Here's the thing.
He's so hot.
No. No, my thing is, it's like, it's about getting people to like you in battle rap,
and
right?
And you know you would lose
like,
the crowd.
Yeah, like, if I lose the crowd, I lost. You know what I'm saying? If I start saying racist.
You call him the N-word?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Like, that's not going to make people go, ooh, we killed it.
Dude. Like, do you have the ability to pull up videos on this, or you guys don't do that? I don't know.
We could, but it's gonna take.
It's
a
gonna
while.
It's gonna take a while. Okay, yeah. I'll just tell you. I'll just tell you. There's this one.
Like, do not. No. He's like, I don't want to watch videos.
We don't pull up videos here. Okay.
Shut the fuck. You think this is you? What you think we got Jamie?
I sent this to you. I sent this video to you because it was a battle rap thing where there's a white dude and he's battling a black dude, and then he goes, "You think I won't say it? I'll fucking say it." Rigor, I'll say the fucking N-word, and then he gets punched before he can even say it.
That video was
like, it comes off screen.
That video is funny and it went viral because the fact that this dude thought, like, in a room full of black rappers, right? He was so comfortable that he was gonna have the pass to say it.
Yo. He thought that my boldness would be respected. Like, they're like, damn, he really isn't scared.
He got punched immediately.
He didn't even finish the word. He didn't finish the word.
I just like the idea that the fist that comes out is a white fist. It's like a white guy punched.
No, it was the rapper.
Yeah, it was the rapper that he was saying. The confidence and the audacity of him was just so fucking funny.
Dude, I never thought about that. The idea that, like, if you lose the crowd of all the black people watching because you say, like, some racist shit, you've lost the battle.
Bro, look at fucking Kramer, dude.
Oh, dude.
We loved Kramer, and then all of a sudden he did it. And then it was like, we don't like him no
okay,
more.
Okay, here's a thought experiment. Let's say there would have been two Asian dudes in the crowd, and they were, like, saying the same exact shit, like, you suck, whatever. And then he starts saying Asian slurs, and then he goes like, 50 years ago, you would have been building the railroads for us. Would anything have happened to him?
No, but I think the crowd would have been like, what? Like, I think they would have lost the crowd.
Yeah, but there's clever ways to say Asian jokes, too, just like in comedy, right?
Like, he wouldn't have had comedy. A video made that made, he wouldn't have got canceled.
Even if people tried to cancel him, I just don't think people would have liked it. Yeah. He wouldn't have been good.
There's hackish ways to say Asian jokes, yeah. But I've heard, like, this is one of the best Asian jokes I heard against me. It's so simple, too. Mm-hmm. And I don't know the exact rhyme to it, but all he said was...
Let me write this down real quick.
The joke was something like... And it was a railroad joke, but the joke was like this. It was so cleverly said. He said, it's so ironic you're a rapper and you can't make tracks. You're an Asian rapper and can't make tracks.
That's pretty good.
That's really good.
That's just so simple, and it's a railroad joke.
That's the thing. You can't be mad at a racist joke if it's good.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, I guess you can, but you shouldn't be.
That's what I'm saying. Some racist Asian jokes, when it crosses more into the cringe side, it doesn't hit on the funny side. So you have to find a balance of that, I think.
And the other thing, too, is like that thing, there's a joke in there as opposed to being like, you would have been building my railroads, is just racist.
Yeah.
It's just like, that doesn't even make sense, kind of.
Dude, I heard this thing that Donald said in an interview that Don Glover said. I'm saying Don, like I know him. I don't know.
Donnie.
Childish was talking. In that one interview where he's like all dressed up in the orange orchard or whatever, he was talking about how, in Atlanta, he's made these things where he's going after people. And it's very clear that like this is a critique of Tyler Perry or something. And the person's like, when you do these things that are so like mean about a specific person, do you ever get mad that they're going to be mad at you? And he's like, no, because they're good. Like if I was like scared about my talent or thought like I sucked or thought like maybe it wasn't to the level, then I would be like scared, like, oh man, I'm gonna get blacklisted or whatever. But because they're good, because someone made a thing about me and was roasting me but it was good, I would be like, oh, that's funny.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah Like I feel like in general with all this, with the climate of how things happen, it's like it just depends on you. Like if you believe that, then you should say what you believe in, you know, no matter what the climate is, you might get the shit on, but that's you, right? But I do believe that us as humans and individuals, like we are changing too. Like we've changed a lot, you know, like as, I mean, 10 years ago, we'd say words that, you know, we don't say back, baby.
Yeah, 10 years ago, we say words that we only used to say in group chats.
And now... But I actually, realistically, yes, that was a fun time of saying those words. But now I actually don't want to say those words either because...
Which words are you talking about?
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying Jake's words like retarded or something like that. Or like fag.
Fag
was a big word, right? Mm-hmm. Like those are words that are harmful to certain people.
So like, battle rap must be really hard right now.
They don't know. Rappers are the most offensive, and that's the whole point.
It's the one area where none of that matters.
Did I send you that video of that one dude? Hey, can you pull it up, dude?
We don't do that.
Jamie.
What do you think this is, bro?
Dude,
you're like, hey, bro, we're still on 4G here. We can't do both at the same time.
It looks like
we could though. Huh? Look at
you
all.
You have
this.
A lot of cameras that aren't on.
I know, it's true.
This looks like if Joe Rogan wore streetwear. That was what his face would look like.
Have you been able to see my face at all this entire podcast? It's been a higher podcast.
Yeah,
Look at my.
It's because you're leaning back so much.
Oh, shit, we gotta stand up
in this, bro. What
dude,
the
we've been
fuck?
Slouching this whole
Yo,
time.
Yo, start this over.
Okay, we gotta do it over. Cut all that.
Cut all this shit, bro.
There's this one video.
I looked awful this entire time. Why did you guys help me?
No, you were fine earlier, bro. You're good.
What the fuck?
You're fine.
I'm sweating and shit.
Yeah, it was getting hot in here. All right, we're gonna wrap up.
Oh, no, this is what I was gonna say.
Say your last thought. Go.
There's this video of another battle rap thing. I don't think I sent this one to you. It's like, it's a black dude going up against like a girl who maybe she's like mixed or something. Maybe she's white. I think she's black. She's black, but this guy's going after her body and he just keeps going. He keeps going. Like he has all these different like adjectives for it. So he just like, you old top of your body look like an unemptied can of toothpaste. You old big ass body bitch. You old. And he keeps saying bitch. And he goes on for like 2 minutes, destroys her.
Yeah.
And then some people in the comments were like, damn, this is like fucking mean, or that's so like, it's misogynistic. But then other people in the comments were like, This battle rap is supposed to be.
Yeah, it was definitely extra as hell. That was one thing. Yeah, of course.
Is it? That's like viral.
What do you mean it was extra? Like he went too far?
All he did for like 5 minutes was like, you big body bitch. You big Heinz ketchup-shaped body bitch. And he just kept doing that.
Wait, was he just rhyming?
It didn't even rhyme.
It didn't rhyme. He would just say like a meme thing and then say body bitch. So he would be like, you all shaped like a Heinz ketchup bottle body bitch. You all top of your body look like a bag of laundry. Bottom half look like some chopsticks ass bitch. And then keep just on and on. And like all of them were killing with the crowd because every time they could be like, oh,
lotion,
yeah, yeah.
I guess like, that was the like bit to the and fact the, he does it that long.
And then he memorized them all.
That's what do you mean he memorized
them? I mean, yeah. I mean, that's the whole point.
I'm just saying that I was like, he's not coming. Like, he memorized so many fucking.
He's like, I'm going to go to this rap thing and not rap. I'm just going to say these ropes.
Like, him thinking of these is so funny to me. Like, writing them down and then, like, practicing, like, Heinz body bitch or Heinz. You know? It's so crazy.
I wonder if he just wrote a bunch and was just like, whatever order. Or is it? Yeah, does he have to say it in a certain order?
I would be like, did I already say? He's like, says Heinz body bitch again.
Did I say that?
Yeah.
Well, I'll repeat that body bitch.
Yeah. He'd be like, I'll say it again. Heinz body bitch.
Everybody's repeating it back to him.
Andrew Lopez, he's been on Platonic on Apple TV. He's been on The Bear on FX. You're killing it, bro. Top 10 writers list. Dude. You're always going, you're touring stand-up in arenas. It's crazy, bro.
Give it up for John Edgar Park. I mean,
you're not helping the name legend, change, bro. Dude. It's Johnny Park, all right?
It's Johnny. Give it up. It's Johnny. Cancel that part
Wait,
out.
Why did you add on the Johnny from John?
Because I just needed to spice things up.
You thought it was
bit.
Just a little bit better?
Are you Johnny Park. How are you spelling it?
Jonnie.
I like that.
You like that, right?
I like that.
You like that?
I like that, bro.
And
that's fire, bro.
I know when Andrew likes it, he knows because he's like he knows showbiz like the back of his hand. You know what I mean? He knows showbiz.
I like that. I also want to say I love your company name. Big Dummy is awesome.
It works even better because it's Big Dummy with an IE.
Yes.
Ah, dude. Big SEO friendly. Okay.
Yeah, bro.
You're getting the usability.
Yo, dude. Let's get you on a list, dude.
It's like you're the one making the list. Let's get you on one of these lists. We're about to make a list. Yeah. You'll be like, best rappers turned actors list. We're going to get you in there at number 7, bro.
Biniam Bizuneh.
Dude, got it right. Okay.
Biniam Bizuneh.
Hey,
my man learned.
Hey.
He's been helping me a lot on these other areas that I'm trying to get into, you know.
Like what?
He's
been
trying to fuck black chicks. So he's really been trying to get into it.
He's been helping me on Hinge. I'm trying to make some Ethiopian food, you know.
Hey, bro, I'm feeling undead today, bro.
Dude, it's all out. I love how it's like, yo, Andrew Lopez, Platonic, The Bear, top 10 writers list. Biniam, he's been helping me get into some shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's been helping me get into some areas to try to get into, like Inglewood. Like, helping me get in.
But you also have some shit in development.
Yeah, bro.
Always.
We've been developing
out here.
We writing.
We all been developing. We're developing fools out here, bro.
What, how's it going in the movie, by the way?
It's good. It's good. Oh, man. Yeah.
How many days left do you have?
One more tomorrow.
Oh, my God. Congrats, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
You fucking did it, man. Like,
dude, crazy. I got a pitch for you. Is he Anderson .Paak in the movie or he's just some guy?
No, he's a character, yeah. He plays
Is he a rapper in it?
No, he's a musician though.
He's a musician. You gotta have a Breezy Lovejoy joke in the movie. Mm-hmm. Where it's like, man, at least you're not going by Breezy Lovejoy anymore.
Well, we're rapping tomorrow, so it's the only chance
the
to
day.
Get it. Where you get it in?
Tomorrow is the day.
Get it as an alt.
Bro, I wanna give you flowers though, dude. I want to say, like, going back to our conversation earlier about always reinventing and always taking risks and stuff, to give you flowers, bro. You have accomplished all of our dreams multiple times in different areas.
You reinvented yourself like 4 times.
And in ways that you have done things that are so hard to do, and you do it with so much like
humility. Dude, Quiz Lady on Hulu. This dude's starring in a big movie.
Thanks, man. Dude, that was fun.
It's fucking crazy that you're gonna 10 years from now. I can't wait to see what you do.
10 years from now. No one's
the world is your playground.
You're gonna drop the Dumbfoundead. Yeah, you're just gonna be Johnny Park.
Johnny Edgar. I think I'm gonna drop that. I might go by Johnny Park.
Bro, I think it's good.
Bro, you gotta go by Johnny spelled with an N-I-E. Eddie D-D-I-E.
Johnny Eddie Park.
Johnny Eddie Park.
Johnny
Johnny Eddie Parky.
There's two I-E's on the thing?
Yeah.
Oh, my
Johnny,
God. That's
Johnny
crazy.
Eddie Parky.
Johnny Eddie Parky.
Johnny Eddie Park is insane. I can't do that.
That's sick, bro.
I can't do that. No more name changes. I'm here. I've settled in.
Dude, here's what's dope, though. You know what you could do? Okay, this is kind of out of the box. You go back to John, but middle initial is E. Johnny Park.
Oh, I was thinking that,
dude,
too.
Oh, Johnny Park.
That was like a runner-up. John E. Park.
John E. Park is sick.
Yeah, but I decided to not. Nah,
dude,
it's
never too late.
All right, Biniam, Andrew Lopez, love you guys. Biniam Bizuneh.
Love you, dummy.
No, dude, you're doing the drop. Right. I like the drop.
I'll never forget it now.
Hey, thanks, Jamie, for pulling up those clips.
Yeah, Jamie.
Tune in next week for another episode. Peace.